If you had asked us a year ago, could you teach 007 virtually? Our answer would have been like, at least I don't know, and maybe I don't think it's possible.
It was pretty difficult to even think about how would you do it.
What was critical for this year's 007 class is that we could provide all the magic and deep engineering learning that comes from our normal hands-on experience of 007, but do it in a remote environment.
The semester-long project is to build robots that complete a series of tasks and score points on a game board. And at the end of the semester, they compete head-to-head to see which robot scores the most points.
So we went through three iterations of a kit of materials we could ship to students wherever they are, develop a game board that the students could drive their robots on, but a little game board that we could ship them anywhere in the world, and still retain the core elements of what we want to teach in 007, like friction, compliance, tolerance stack up, over constraint in a COVID compatible way.
For me, 2007 was the first time that I heard our class is virtual, but by the way, we're sending you hundreds of pounds of material and you're gonna really get to work. Right now I'm taking 2007 from an apartment in West Roxbury, and basically I'm working from the bedroom, from the kitchen, from outside where the shoes are by the door, and anywhere that there's space that I can use. I feel like this semester I did not miss out on the 2007 experience because even though I wasn't able to use the big machines in the shop, I have so much more experience with hand tools now. The staff support is pretty hands-on. Even though you're working from home.
In virtual environment, it's pretty challenging to teach techniques associated with the tools and materials. To counter that, we actually videotaped a lot of actions from the instructors, how to build many different things.
Anybody who's thinking of doing something similar can see, like, what does this look like in real life?
So that has become really, really helpful.
My game board is chilling in the Baker Lounge right now. I know that whatever mechanism I want to come up with, there are ways to build it using the items in the kit, which is really cool.
The 2007 staff has been the most understanding and nurturing that I've ever encountered.
We always had virtual meeting tools.
Hey, Tolu.
But now everybody's at home. We can schedule meeting with students a lot more flexible way. Our time with the student actually is increased.
I'm in a space where I felt my progress throughout my whole life. Behind me, I have pictures of my kindergarten diploma, and now I'm working on a robot for 2007. Without being there in person, you make a lot more mistakes, but eventually you get them right, and you learn a lot along the way.
My dad has a saying, like, you are how you are wherever you are, so you can get it done anywhere. Just get it done.
The theme of this year's competition is Home Alone, Together.
Welcome everybody to the 2021 007 competition.
We wanted them to still retain the camaraderie and the celebration, even if they couldn't come to campus.
On competition night, it'll be a great thing to come together and see everyone else's robots and compete and hopefully win. I'm not gonna win, but we'll see.
We try to keep that excitement of the competition as much as possible while keeping everybody safe.
We went into this year thinking, oh, virtual's gonna be worse. And in so many cases we found this year, virtual's actually better. Having the tools and materials at home tremendously promotes the quality of their fabrication and their ability to iterate their designs.
They gained that technique so much quicker and so much early on. So that allowed them to think and plan their design process a lot more practical, a lot more realistic.
And what's been so gratifying in this semester is the robot fabrication and the quality of the fabrication is better than we've ever seen before.